I do word a day and I love it. My word of the day the other day in my email was rip snorter. That like a party could be a real rip snorter. And that's mine forever now because I'm going to use that one. My father was easily impressed by everyone. He just sort of gave me the impression that the world was rooting for me. He always used to say, "Oh, I love you, you're gonna write the great American novel someday." And I thought, boy, that would be the thrill of a lifetime to hand him a book that I wrote. I was 36 with two kids in diapers and I had discovered a pretty big tumor in my breast. And so I went over to my friend's house, who is an OBGYN, and I took my shirt off on her sofa in front of my daughters, who were one and two. And she kind of felt me up on the sofa. And she said, you gotta go have it looked at tomorrow. The doctor said, "I'm very concerned." And I said, "Why are you concerned?" And he said, "Because it looks like an explosion." Talk about words. Like, really? You wanna say explosion to a 36-year-old who's like holding back tears? That's not a good choice, doctor. And so I started chemotherapy right away. And then while I was in chemotherapy, my father was diagnosed with cancer. His was more complex because of his age and because of some previous health issues. And so we were really told to have a great year and not to have quote unquote outrageous expectations for more. I was in panic and I sort of spent that panic energy on writing. I just felt like, you can't possibly let this man die without telling him with sufficient emphasis what it has been to be his kid. If I were to try to say to him, "God, you were a great dad," or you're like the foundation of my life, he would say, "Oh, love you, love you, love you," and he'd switch it back to me. So it really had to be a book because I had to have uninterrupted space on the page to say, no, this is gonna take more than a minute. This is gonna take 300 pages. There is no quantifying how thrilling it was to go on that ride with my dad. I mean, he came to readings, he signed books with me, he shook hands with people. It was the absolute dream come true of all dreams. And if nothing ever good ever happens to me again, I got more than I needed. My name is Kelly Corrigan, and this is my brief but spectacular take on the power of words.